Hey everyone, Jeff here coming to you today here from the Magic Kingdom. Today, of course, is October 1st, 2021, the 50th anniversary of Walt Disney World Resort and the Magic Kingdom. Today, got here super early for a super early start. Got here around 3:30. Very smooth getting on the monorail and getting over here, but once they opened up the gates, that's when the chaos started. And you'll see that here as I have what the Emporium looked like right after the opening. Just craziness. It seems like Disney wasn't too prepared for this, which is kind of sad, honestly. But anyways, I think today is going to be taking in all of the Magic Kingdom's new festivities, especially for the 50th anniversary. There might be a stage ceremony, some sort of opening show we're gonna check out. So there's a brand new 50th anniversary themed cavalcade for today and tonight, the debut to the general public of Disney Enchantment. So let's go check things out.
We wish you a magical day here at the Magic Kingdom as we celebrate Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary.
Just spotted some Disney executives here. You can see there in the center, we have Bob Chapek. I believe that's Jeff Valley right in front of him, and Park Chairman Josh D'Amaro right there as well. Looks like they're going through some interviews for the day, and they are going around. All right, guys, so I will say it is only after 9 o'clock now, but today is a very special day and I wanted to treat myself, so I went to Aloha Isle and got to meet Dole Whip. I got the Tropical Serenade Float, which is pineapple juice, coconut soft serve, and a upside down pineapple cake pop on top of it. It looks really delicious, very refreshing, and I can't wait to give this a try. But I will say, this is absolutely delicious, very refreshing on a hot day like it is today. Highly recommend getting it. So Disney actually does have some day of merch here for today. As if you were a guest that was in attendance at Magic Kingdom on October 1st, they have some special merchandise for that. However, they really didn't give many details for that besides outside the Emporium this morning. And I think a lot of guests didn't realize that if you want a day of merch, it would be right here. But we're gonna go inside now and give that a look. Right, so I have just obtained some 50th anniversary day of merchandise. I'll go over that in a later video, but now since it is Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary and it's only fitting to do an attraction that debuted on October 1st, 1971, I think now we're going to check out Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room.
Okay, okay.
coming now. Mickey's celebrational cavalcade. Here it is. So as I've updated you guys over the Disney Roundup for the past month or so, the Fab 50 character statues are here inside the parks, and this one has to be my favorite hands down. Stitch over here in Tomorrowland by the famous, world famous purple wall, but he looks amazing. I really like too with him, he's actually hanging on the wall right here, and he has that 50th crest he's biting on them. That's just awesome. So with it being Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary, thinking about new offerings that are coming to the resort this year, one thing came to mind that did not open in time for the 50th anniversary that was supposed to, that is the Tron Light Cycle Run Coaster. Go ahead and check it on its progress now. All right, there it is. Construction still being taken place over on Tron's like a run coaster. Honestly, since I was last here on July 1st for the Happily Ever After fireworks return, it looks fairly the same. You can see down here we have one worker working down there, but other than that, I don't see that much difference. It is quite disappointing that we didn't get the Tron coaster in time for the 50th anniversary, but who also knows as well if it'll be available for Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary at all, as it was just mentioned the other day that Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind would be opening in 2022 at some point, but no mention of Tron. So just got an update on the My Disney Experience app a few minutes ago, and it says park hopper option is temporarily unavailable at Magic Kingdom Park. So, all guests who are here to see Disney Enchantment tonight are here, as no more guests are allowed. I think now I'm going ahead and go ahead too and pick out a good spot. Try to get a good spot so I can take in some of the projections that are going down Main Street, as that's said to be one of the big things with Enchantment. Just a little bit after 7 right now, and the crowds of people are flooded in. Everybody is ready to see the new fireworks show, Disney Enchantment, tonight. Fireworks don't start until 9 o'clock now for Disney Enchantment, but people still really want to see this show and are packing in the place. The one thing I almost forgot is tonight Cinderella Castle will be transforming into its Beacon of Magic. It's supposed to start around herd 7:45 or so. We're going to be looking for it then. I'm looking forward to this. I think it's going to be really cool.
Good evening, friends. Look around. There is a special magic that flows through this land. A magic of fantasy. Swirling with pixie dust made more brilliant by the light that lives within you. It inspires us to wish upon stars, follow our hearts, and find our happily ever afters. Tonight, as we gather together under the spires of this majestic castle, our dreams ignite the magic to create a beacon shining out and celebrate 50
You need to be there.
everyone. Sorry I forgot to record a goodbye while I was at Magic Kingdom. Yesterday was amazing, but it was a very long day. I think I mentioned I was up or there in line to get into Magic Kingdom around 3:30 a.m. and didn't leave until about, I think it was about 10:30 or so. It was just a very long day. It was a very good day, a very magical day. A little iffy to the start, like I mentioned. I don't think Disney really prepared that well. Everybody just ran to the Emporium like they didn't have a queue or a line set up until later that day. And some unfortunate things happened that day. I heard, I believe, allegedly, punches were thrown, cast members were knocked down. So, very sorry to hear about that. Other than that, most of the day was pretty good. I was a little disappointed, though. I did think Disney was going to do an opening ceremony for the 50th anniversary. It looks like they just started off with their new castle stage show. No ceremony, but I did hear that they did do the induction the night before at the media event where they live streamed Disney Enchantment for the first time. So I guess they didn't want to do anything today for whatever reason, which was a little disappointing. Overall, a very fantastic day. And what I think about Disney Enchantment. So I've been hearing a lot of mixed reviews when it comes to Disney Enchantment. And here's my thoughts on it. I like Disney Enchantments. I don't hate Disney Enchantments. I really like the music in Enchantment. You Are the Magic. Really like that soundtrack. Really good. Some of the fireworks bursts in the show were really good. Very colorful ones too. The issues I have with it is, you know, I'm biased when it comes to Happily Ever After. So the fact that it's a new permanent show instead of temporary is where, because it's, in my opinion, it's not better, and I think a lot of people agree it's not better than Happily Ever After. So I would like it a little bit more knowing it's just temporary than permanent. The other thing I was disappointed by was the projections that went down Main Street. Now on my video that I captured Enchantment on, you can see the projections a little bit on the sides on the Main Street buildings, but if you turn around and look even down Main Street or just to your side, the projections are very dim. They're not very crisp and clear, and you can see what's on there, but still yet, I would like them to be a little bit better than what they were. And really, the projections, they're cool and all, but I didn't think they played a real key part into the show. If you just look at some of the things, it's mainly just like pictures of things or like snow or during Be Our Guest. There's food on there, so really not what I was hoping or expecting. It seems Tinkerbell in the show comes and flies in out of nowhere. I know it's going to be hard to top, or even if it's possible to top, how Tink comes out during Happily Ever After. I really do like the Frozen 2 scene the best out of the entire show. I think it's really cool how they include Into the Unknown from Panic by the Disco. Love that. The crowd loved it as well. But yes, Disney Enchantment, is it fine? Yes. Do I hate it? No. Is it better than Happily Ever After? I guess you have to decide for yourself. For me, that's a no, but overall, Magic Kingdom on October 1st was amazing. I'm so grateful and thankful I was able to be there. Thank you all for watching this video. There will be one more vlog coming out from this weekend. Today, actually, I will be in Epcot riding Remy's Ratatouille Adventure for the very first time. A little anxious to ride that, but we will give that a go. If you enjoyed this video, though, please make sure to hit that like button for me and subscribe to my channel, because I'll be posting more 50th anniversary videos in the near future. Until next time, I will see you all next time.